Sir Thomas.
Richard.
I fell. Lady Alice. Lady Margaret.
Good evening.
Do you know William Roper the Younger?
By reputation, of course.
Good evening, Master...
Rich.
Oh!
You've heard of me?
Yes.
In what connection? I don't know what you can have heard. I sense that I'm not welcome here.
Why, Richard, have you done something to make you not welcome?
Cromwell is asking questions about you. He's continually asking questions about you and your opinions.
Of whom?
Of him? Oh, what? That's one of his sources.
Of course, that's one of my servants. All right, Matthew.
Will you look at me as though I were an enemy?
Why, Richard, you're shaking.
Help me.
How?
Employ me.
No.
Employ me?
No.
I would be faithful.
Richard, you couldn't answer for yourself even so far as tonight.
Arrest him.
For what?
He's dangerous.
A libel. He's a spy.
Father, that man's bad.
There's no law against that.
There is God's law.
Then God can arrest him.
While you talk, he's gone.
And go he should if he were the devil himself until he broke the law.
So, now you'd give the devil benefit of law.
Yes, what would you do? Cut a great road through the law to get after the devil?
Yes. I'd cut down every law in England to do that.
Oh? And when the last law was down and the devil turned round on you, where would you hide, Roper? The law's all being flat. This country is planted thick with laws from coast to coast, man's laws, not God's. And if you cut them down, and you're just the man to do it, do you really think you could stand upright in the winds that would blow then? Yes, I'd give the devil benefit of law for my own safety's sake.